At first glance, Stella Terra doesn't look really beautiful and modern, especially from some angles. But don't let the outdated appearance deceive you. This vehicle is engineered by a team of students and scientists from the Eindhoven University of Technology in the Netherlands. They started as a project made by enthusiasts, and more companies joined the project. Now the Terra family of cars is supported by Siemens and also a bunch of European companies acting as sponsors for the project of a completely sustainable car and arguably the world's first solar off-road vehicle. So the Stella Terra has a pretty unusual design of the rear part of the car. The reason is simple, they wanted to place more solar panels, so they needed more surface, and the designers came up with the idea of a retro-style rear end of the car to help them produce more energy and make the EV more efficient. The project wasn't based on any existing car model. Actually, the project manager, Vise Boss, claims that in order to make the car as lightweight as possible, they had to engineer almost every single part on their own, including suspension, body parts, and even inverters that transmit the power from solar panels to the battery. Now let's look at some figures. The Stella Terra is capable of 90 miles per hour maximum speed. It has four electric motors. These are the so-called hub motors, in-wheel motors. Each wheel is powered by a dedicated motor, which creates unlimited possibilities for electronic safety and traction control programming in the future. Also, this type of construction leaves more space because there is no central drivetrain, and they could pack the vehicle with more batteries. The most important thing is that the Stella Terra is capable of driving about 440 miles or 710 kilometers a day without using a single kilowatt from the grid. It takes all its power from the sun only. Of course, this is a very disputable claim, but the vehicle was actually tested in Morocco. It was driven on sandy roads of Africa for about 1,000 kilometers for several days. Of course, you will expect to get more sun in the Sahara than in any average European city, so the real-life daily mileage will be way more limited than that. Interestingly, during that trip in Morocco, the team had trouble with steering system and they could successfully repair this Stella Terra using parts from local stores. But anyway, the figures are just mind-blowing. On average, the Stella Terra could drive about 250 to 300 miles a day off-roading or in the city traffic on a sunny day. Of course, if there are clouds in the sky, you will expect these figures to drop close to zero, but you still have a 50 kWh battery pack and can use the energy that the vehicle gained yesterday. So if you drive on average 20-30 miles a day, you may expect that the Stella Terra would cover all your driving with just the sun energy. And it will likely power your house with the remaining kilowatts. Engineers also added power sockets so that you could use some energy for cooking or using other appliances when you are off-roading. But let's face it, such a vehicle will most likely cost too much with the current technologies. The team has never disclosed the total price of the project, and they also engineered a lot of parts and units on their own, so it's impossible to count the price of the prototype. But one part of the team created the commercial solar electric vehicle called Lightyear Zero. You can potentially buy one for 120,000 euros, but the problem is that it has worse and cheaper technologies, and it will most likely cover only up to 20 miles of your driving a day with solar energy, and that's on a sunny day. So as the creators of this solar off-road vehicle say, it was created to motivate large industry players like BMW or Land Rover to create more sustainable technologies.